Okay, so very good evening everyone. Today we are going to cover the first periodic trend, and which is for atomic size. Okay, so before going to understand atomic size, we have to understand what is atomic radius. Okay, so atomic radius means what? So I'm writing here heading atomic radius. Atomic radius. As we know, we have considered as atoms are spherical in shape. As we have considered as atoms are spherical in shape. That means the atomic size can be determined by the atomic radius only. And what is atomic radius? It is the distance from center of nucleus to the outermost shell. Okay, so here we have the outermost shell. Outermost shell. And here we have the center of nucleus. Center of nucleus. Okay, so the distance from center of nucleus to the outermost shell of an atom is called as atomic radius. And atomic size is determined by atomic radius only. Is it? Is it or not? Yes, so we have to understand atomic radius. Okay, so the distance from center of nucleus to the outermost shell of an atom. Outermost shell of an atom is called as atomic radius. Atomic radius. And very important point, atomic size is determined by atomic radius. Okay, if atomic radius is higher will be the atomic size. Therefore, atomic radius is directly proportional to atomic size. Atomic size. Understood, everyone?
Yes.
So take a screenshot for that. Okay. So now we are going to understand trend of atomic radius in groups as well as in period. So we know when we are moving left to right, it is means period. And when we are moving top to bottom, then it is the group. Is it group and period? Okay, so first we will check atomic or trend of atomic radius in group first. So I'm just writing here trends. Trend of atomic radius or size. You can use radius or size also. Okay, in group. Okay, so see here, I'm discussing about the first group. So first element, we have helium, then we have lithium, then we have sodium, likewise, we have again potassium, okay? So as we are moving top to bottom in a group, okay, so see here, this is the first period, second period, third period, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh, is it? So if we are discussing about the hydrogen have only one electron, so it require only one shell. Okay, it require only one shell in order to acquire one electron. After that, we have lithium. So lithium have atomic number 2, okay? So lithium will require two shells. 1 and 2. Then we have sodium, beta. Sodium having atomic number 11. So sodium will have 1, 2, and 3 shell. Likewise, again we have potassium having 19 electron. So it will require 1, 2, 3, and 4. So see, as we are moving top to bottom, okay, each time new cells are added here. Is it? Here we are having only one shell, here we have 2 shell, here we have 3 shell, here we have 4 shell. Is it? Do reply. Yes. So when we are moving top to bottom, new shells are added each time. New shells are added each time, due to which the distance from center of nucleus to outermost shell increases all the time. That means atomic radius increases. If atomic radius increases, that means atomic size also increases. So this is the trend for atomic radius in group. So now I'm going to write here, when we move top to bottom, new shells are added, or top to bottom along with group, new shells are added each time. Okay, due to which atomic radius increases. Is it? Due to which atomic radius increases. Hence, atomic size also increases. Atomic size also increases along with group. Okay, therefore here we can say hydrogen have less atomic size than lithium, then lithium have less atomic size than sodium, then sodium have less atomic size than potassium, etc. It is K only. Okay, understood? Everyone do reply?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the trend for atomic radius. So take a screenshot. Now we are going to discuss the atomic trend of atomic radius in period. So take a screenshot that first. Done. Okay, so now we are going to understand atomic trend or atomic radius trend in periods. So I'm writing here in periods. Okay, so I'm going to discuss about the second period or third period, that one. Okay, so first we have sodium. So I'm writing here sodium. Sodium have atomic number 11 and its electronic configuration is 2, 8, and 1. Then we have magnesium. So I'm writing here the nucleus. Then this is the first shell, second shell, and third shell. So sodium have one electron in its outermost shell. Here 2 electron, here 8 electron, and here 1. Now magnesium. Magnesium have atomic number 12. That means its electronic configuration is 2, 8, and 2. Means in third cell, one electron is increased here. If electron will increase atomic, due to increase in electron in third cell, one proton is also added here, because all the atoms, they contain equal number of electron and proton. Is it? If electron is added in the same cell, that means proton will also add here. Is it or not? Now we are going to discuss about aluminium. aluminium have atomic number 13. So its electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 3. See here, we are having one electron, then here 2, then now 3. That means in same cell, again, one electron is added. That means one proton will also add here. Now we are going to discuss about silicon. Silicon have atomic number 14. So its electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 4. So here also one more electron will add here. If electron will add, proton will also add. So as you can see here, when we are moving left to right, okay, left to right in period, each time electrons are added in the same cell, in third cell only. Is it everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So due to addition of electron and proton in nucleus, the positive charge of nucleus increases. It is called as increase in nuclear charge. Okay. So due to increase in nuclear charge, the force of attraction between electron of outermost shell and nucleus increases all the time. Okay, due to which that outermost shell all the time slightly pulls toward the nucleus. Okay, it will pull toward the nucleus slightly. Okay, so that means atomic radius decreases. Okay, due to increase in nuclear charge, force of attraction between nucleus and electron of outermost shell increases, due to which atomic radius decreases. If atomic radius decreases, means size will decrease. Understood, everyone?
Yes, I understood.
Yeah. So now we are going to write in word form here. Okay. So when we move left to right along with period, when we move left to right along with period, electrons are added in a same shell. See here, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, then again here we have phosphorus, then sulfur, then we have chlorine, then we have argon. Okay, so all elements will have three cells. 2, 8, 5, then 2, 8, 6, then 2, 8, 7, then 2, 8, 8. Okay, so they will have all three cells only, but each time one electron is added in outermost shell. So due to addition of electron in outermost cell, proton will also increase because all the atom contain equal number of electron and proton. So increase in proton in nucleus is called as increase in nuclear charge. Okay. So when we move left to right along with period, electrons are added in the same cell, due to which nuclear charge increases. Due to increase in nuclear charge, or which leads to increase the force of attraction between electron of outermost shell and nucleus. That force is called as beta Coulombic force. Okay, Coulomb force. That force is called as Coulomb force because it is due to the charge on electron and proton. That's why it is called as Coulombic force. So the force of attraction increases, increase the force of attraction between electron of outermost shell and nucleus. Okay, which leads to or due to which outermost cell slightly, not much, only slightly pulls towards the nucleus. Okay, hence atomic radius decreases. Therefore, atomic size also decreases. Left to right in period. Okay, understood everyone, or any doubt here?
Understood, sir.
Okay, so take a screenshot here. Okay, so we have to understand this with the help of example. So oxygen, I'm just writing here randomly, then we will arrange that. Okay, so oxygen have atomic number 6. Okay, its electronic configuration is 2 and 4. Okay, and its atomic radius, I'm writing here atom, then here we have electronic configuration, and here I'm writing atomic radius. Okay, so its atomic radius is 66 pm. You know, pm is picometer, beta, picometer. Okay, and 1 picometer equals to 1 into 10 to the power minus 12 meter. You just have to remember that. Okay, atomic radius is very, very small length. That's why we used to measure it in picometer. Okay, and 1 picometer is equals to 1 into 10 to the power minus 12 meter. Okay, mean it's 0.0000 up to 12 time and then 1. Okay, then we have boron. Its atomic number is 5. Again, electronic configuration is 2 and 5, so 3 here. Its atomic radius is 88 picometer. I'm writing here picometer. Then carbon, atomic number is 6. Okay, so or we should write here here oxygen is 8, beta, oxygen is 8. So here 6 electron will come. Atomic number of oxygen is 8. Carbon have 6. So its atomic electron configuration is 2 and 4. And its atomic radius is 77 picometer. Then we have nitrogen. Its atomic number is 7. Its electronic configuration is 2 and 5. And its atomic radius is 74 picometer. Then we have beryllium, Be. Its atomic number is 4. And 2 and 2 will be electronic configuration. And its atomic radius is 111 picometer. Then we have lithium. Atomic number is 3. And electronic configuration is 2 and 1, and its atomic radius is 152 picometer. Okay, so see here, the lithium will come here first. Okay, so here we have lithium. After lithium, we have beryllium. So I'm writing here beryllium. After beryllium, we have boron. Here we have boron. So I'm writing here boron. It's 3 here, 4, 5. After boron, we have carbon. So I'm writing here carbon 6. Then we have nitrogen. I'm writing here nitrogen. Then we have oxygen here and oxygen. Okay. So see, lithium have atomic radius 152 and which is greater than 111 and which is the atomic radius of beryllium. Then for boron, its atomic number is 5. We have 88. Okay, and which is small, less than the beryllium. Then we have for carbon. So carbon have atomic radius of 77. Okay, then it is again smaller than boron. Then for nitrogen, we have 74 picometer. And for oxygen, we have 66 picometer. 66. See here, lithium, see, when we are moving left to right, here we have the left and in this side we have right side. Okay, so when we are moving left to right and it is the period along with period. Okay. Atomic radius decreases, as you can see here. Is it everyone? Do reply.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is for period. Now we will discuss for group also. So here we have lithium. Lithium have atomic number 3. Instead, I'm just writing its atomic radius and which is 152. We already discussed here 152. After that lithium, we have sodium. So sodium have atomic number 11 and its atomic radius is 186. Someone is in waiting room. Wait a second. Chanchal. Okay. After sodium, we have beta potassium. Its atomic number is 19. And its atomic radius is, potassium is 231. After potassium, we have rubidium. It's Rb. Okay. And its atomic number is 37. 37 and its atomic radius is 244. Then we have cesium, Cs. Its atomic number is 55 and its atomic radius is 262. See here, when we are moving, this is the top and here we have bottom. Sorry. So when we are moving top to bottom, it is the group. So when we are moving top to bottom along with group C, all the time atomic radius is increases. Is it 152, 186, 231, 244, 262? Is it everyone?
Yes, sir.
So this is due to the addition of new shell all the time for having next new electron there. Okay, that's why new shells are being added when we are moving top to bottom. So again, take a screenshot for that. The red one is for period and the blue one is for group. This is example. So here we have completed the trend of atomic radius and atomic size in group as well as in period. Now we are going to understand what is valency and how it varies in groups as well as in period. So first we have to understand what is valency. So valency is the combining capacity of any element. Okay. So the combining capacity of an element is called as valency. okay, and valence is determined by number of electrons present in their outermost shell. I'm writing here, valency is determined by number of electrons present in outermost shell of an atom. Outermost shell of an atom. Okay, understood everyone? What is valence is?
Yes, I understood.
Okay, so now we are going to cover the trend of valency in group first. So trend, okay, of valency in group. Okay, so first we are going to discuss about first group. So in case of hydrogen, okay, hydrogen have atomic number 1, so its valence, so its electronic configuration is 1. Okay, so it require 1 electron to complete its duplex rule. Okay, so its valency will be 1. Now here we have sodium. Sodium have atomic number 11. So its electronic configuration will be 2, 8 and 1. So according to the octet rule, says beta, in order to acquire stability, every element must contain 8 electron in their outermost shell. But in case of sodium, we have only 1 electron in its outermost shell. Its octet is complete? No, it's not complete. So now sodium has two conditions, whether it is going to lose 1 electron or may gain 7 electron. So what is going to be easy for sodium? To lose 1 electron or to gain 7 electron?
To lose 1 electron.
Yes, means its valency again 1. Now we will discuss about potassium having atomic number 19. So its electronic configuration will be 2, 8, 8 and 1. So again, its valency is 1. So as we are moving top to bottom, number of electron present in outermost shell same, equal or constant. Because here any element will come, they will contain 1 electron in their outermost shell. For group 2, any element will present have 2 electron in their outermost shell. Is it or not? Is it?
Yes.
So due to presence of equal number of electron in their outermost shell, they have all valency equal, same. That means valency does not change in group. Okay, so valency will remain constant in group. So let me write the theoretical part for that. When we move top to bottom, along with group, number of electron, in valence shell, of an atom remains same, hence valency will also same. Valency will also remain same. Therefore, valency does not change. Valency remains constant. In group. Okay, understood everyone? Means element of same group have same valency. Therefore, element of same group have same valency. Okay, so this is the trend for valency in groups. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, I understood.
Okay. So now we are going to understand trend of valency in periods now. So trend of valency in period. In period. Very important. See, again, I'm discussing the same period for sodium. So we have sodium. Its atomic number is 11 and its electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 1. So its valency will be 1 because it is going to lose one electron. After sodium, we have magnesium having atomic number 12. So its electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 2. Again, magnesium will lose 2 electrons. Hence, its valency is 2. Now we have aluminium. Atomic number is 13. So its electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 3. So again, aluminum will going to lose 3 electrons. So its valency is 3. After aluminum, we have silicon. Atomic number 14. Electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 4. Again, it may lose or gain 2 electrons. So 4 electrons. So its valency is 4.
Oh.
Yes. After that, we have phosphorus. Atomic number is 15. So electronic configuration is 2, 8
and 5.
And 5.
It will see. Lose 3 electrons.
No, it will gain 3 electrons. See, in order to have in order to have 8 electrons, according to the octet rule, in order to have 8 electrons, phosphorus have two conditions: to lose 5 electrons or to gain 3 electrons. So to gain 3 electrons will be easy for phosphorus. So its valency will be 3. After phosphorus, we have sulfur. Atomic number is 16. So 2, 8, and 6. So valency will be 2. Because in order to have 8 electrons, it will gain 2 electrons. Okay. So if we'll gain 2 electrons, that means valency will be 2. After sulfur, we have chlorine. Atomic number is 17. 2, 8, 7 will be electronic configuration. So it will gain 1 electron. Okay. That means valency will be 1. Then we have argon. Atomic number is 18. So 2, 8, 8 will be the electronic configuration. So see, it is having 8 electron in its outermost shell according to the octet rule. So it is not going to lose or gain electrons. So its valence will be 0. Is it? Is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when we are moving left to right, valency first increases from 1 to 4. Okay. And then decreases from 4 to 0. Is it or not? So this is the trend. Okay. So now we are going to write here. When... Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So when we move from left to right. Drashi, understood? Along with?
Yes, sir.
Along with period, valency first increases from 1 to 4 and then decreases from 4 to 0. Okay, so this is the trend for valency in periods. It's really very easy, no? And this is for the example. Okay. Any doubt here?
No doubts.